Social Tech Training was designed to really give people the A to Z of how to become online superstars. It's more of an MBA program for social media, social change, than it is a conference. So we're really hoping people get, you know, tons of new ideas and tons of new websites to look at and network, but also something very practical, which is a very tangible Web 2 plan, an evolution plan for their online work that they can take back to their organization. So we're trying to train up people that are maybe accidental techies or been asked to do this and they don't have all the skills. So we've got an interesting mix of 65 individuals who work inside social change organizations. So those organizations, well-known ones like Greenpeace and Suzuki Foundation, Care Canada, Street Kids International. The other category of people here is our trainers. We've got about 29 support people and trainers who are more senior people in the space. And that's sort of the magic of this event, is to be able to have a really kind of high ratio of a bit more senior leaders to people that are more newer to this space.
So the problems that we have in the world today, they're totally different from the problems of the past. To tackle them, we're going to need the kind of solutions that are radically different than the solutions that have been implemented in the past.
This is actually territory where NGOs can really start to affect some changes in how people relate to each other by encouraging people to take a more active role and a more conversational approach to change. Helping as many organizations as possible, as quickly as possible, start to realize the potential of these tools that can really help them engage people in those critical conversations is the only way we're going to make the turn the corner.
There's so many organizations who say, oh, I think the internet's important, but how do we really execute a strategy? How do we implement these actionable tactics? And hopefully, at gatherings like this, enough people will be trained up so that they can fill those positions and organizations can start to use this incredible new communications tool that we have.
And they're being taught about how to use modern internet and technology tools to reach out to folks, how to use Facebook and online video and blogs and Google and all that kind of stuff to really get their message out.
Flickr and Facebook and these things are Web 2. Making your organization engage in a Web 2 world doesn't just mean creating a Facebook profile. It means actually having a strategy for how you're going to engage people in a whole new way. How are you going to actually have a conversation with people? How are you going to change the way that your organization works?
Those are tools to be able to enhance our relationships with one another. And when we're in stronger relationship with one another, then we can have ability to do powerful, impactful social change work is that much more enhanced.
I think what we're seeing is some buy-in into the idea that Web 2.0 is people using whatever tools they have at hand to share ideas and to collaborate.
People are excited about each other's organizations and what's happening and firing off lots of ideas. Everybody's got lots to contribute to each other's plans.
I've been inspired. Change of thinking to a common communication strategy style, you know, the static brochure website, it's got to go.
Everybody in the room, I think, has gotten real value out of, you know, at least some pieces of it. And I think for a lot of people, I suspect that's going to prove quite transformative in their work.
I'm not a tech person. My brain was going like 1,000 times faster than it should have been because there's so much energy and there's so much think activity in this. But once I got in here, I was instantly refreshed. The minute I heard somebody started talking, I just opened up my notes, I started writing again. I feel like I have some knowledge now.
We'll see more and more social organizations coming out of here that are embracing these new technologies and being able to use them to the best advantage.
You know, the only reason we're able to do this is because of Mars and SIGS. The Social Innovation Generation Group, the funders, and Mars really feel like there's something in social tech that really relates to how social change happens. That maybe there's something in organizations becoming more open and more collaborative that could actually facilitate more social change and more social innovation and a better world for everyone.
It can really be, you know, the beginning of an entire generation of activists who are totally wired and engaged and connected to these, you know, smart networks that learn together as they grow together.
We have more of a power now than ever to communicate with people all around the world really quickly, to find people who think like us, and to if we can control the communication channels, we can get the messages to the people.
This stuff works. That's if there's anything we learned this week, is like people build lists, they engage people, they raise money, they make change, and they help people feel engaged in this world of such disconnection. So I want to see these organizations like open up, you know, crack open, let the light shine through, let their whole self come out, let others come in, others' energy come in to help them in their amazing work, and really kind of lift this whole sector forward.